There are a lot of great things that you see above the ground in the city, and you can admire them and just amazed at how did they build that. Yet with the water and sewer utility, everything's under the ground. One of the things that the EPA requires us to do is to do a better job of managing the utility and doing the maintenance work that's required. The EPA was charged with the responsibility to enforce the Clean Water Act, and two requirements that they have related to the pipes we have in the ground is to clean them on a regular basis and to actually inspect them. Several things that we're finding are things that could have been fixed years ago. We're going to take care of the things that we know once we find a problem, we're going to take care of it. And that's what we're charged with doing.
The crews are here today to replace or to repair a broken lateral. The broken lateral failed, causing a street collapse. We have well over 100 collapses a year.
One of the things I find is very few people really understand how massive the wastewater infrastructure is in the city here. We have two wastewater treatment plants that were built back in the mid-50s. There's over 800 miles of sewer lines spread throughout Evansville and into the county area. The wastewater treatment plants process probably close to 30 million gallons a day. It's phenomenal when you think about that, the amount of volume that we treat and process every day.
Well, to this point, we've simply been fixing the breaks. Typical sewer lines should last from 50 to 80 years. Parts of the system are well over 100 years old. So we're just experiencing an increase in breakage and collapse simply because of the age of this system. You know, we spend 30 cents on the dollar if we can get ahead of the problem before it becomes a major collapse. Yeah, you know, one of the main components of the consent decree proposal that the city of Evansville has given the Department of Justice is green infrastructure projects. And it's an attempt to collaborate with other departments in their capital plans to incorporate stormwater redirection from those projects. The biggest is the back parking lot for the Civic Center. It essentially eliminates 6 million gallons of stormwater into our system every year. So it was a very successful and a very cost beneficial project. And 2 years ago, we didn't do our own inspections in-house. In fact, we had to, in 2011, we had to hire those inspections out at the tune of $1.2 million. We completed those in-house last year. We essentially reduced cost for the utility by $800,000. We've had a lot of lift stations that we are rehabilitating with this program as well. We completed 6 of them last year. It's about catching up with a system that's been somewhat neglected for the last 60 years. One of our largest capital investments are these pipes that we never see. To catch up in 28 years for something that's been 60 years behind is it's going to be a pretty big feat.